Question number 13. Ram has done 1/5 of work and Shyam has done 1/3 of it. Suppose your teacher has given you some work and you are not doing that alone, you are doing that with a friend. So in case of projects, you have seen chart papers, we have seen you don't do the entire work alone. You do in a group. So the entire work is divided between two friends, and how much they are contributing, how much they are doing? One friend is doing 1/5 of the work. That means if I divide the entire work into 5 equal parts, then he is doing only one part, whereas the other friend Shyam is doing 1/3. So if I divide the work into 3 pieces, he is doing one part of it. So these are the distribution in between the friend that is given, how much they are doing, what part of the whole work is done. Now here, what is the question? What part means, what is the fraction of work that is done by both of them? Another question is there, what part of work is left out? So there are two questions. What is the fraction? Part means fraction. So your answer here should be in fraction. What part of the work? Suppose in the previous question we have found what is the total income. If they ask you what is the part of saving, so you have to express. When the question is having what is the part of saving, what is the part of work done, you have to express in fraction. But what is actual saving, what is actual income, you have to express in its respective unit, that is in rupees. So here the question is, what part of work is done by both of them? If they individually do this much work, the fractions are provided, and what is the part left out? So very easy question. What you will do, part or fraction, the question is what part of whole work is done. So you will write fraction or part of work done equal to, add up what they are doing individually, 1/5 plus 1/3. And if you add up, this is fractional addition, what I said, when you have to add numbers like this, you have to take out the LCM and change into common denominator. Now what will be the LCM of 5 and 3? Both are prime numbers. So in case if all the denominators are prime numbers, we just multiply to find the LCM. So 5 is a 15. Now compare the denominators and write what should be the numbers at the top. 5 into 3 gives you 15. That 3 you multiply with 1. So 3 ones are 3. Plus 3 5s are 15. That 5 you multiply with its numerator. 5 ones are 5. So 8 by 15 is the total fraction of work done by both of them. So this is the first answer, that is fraction of work done by both of them is 8 by 15. The next question is, what part of work is left out? So when you are doing the work and not finished, the entire work is taken as 1. Now out of that, the part of work that is done by you has to be subtracted to know how much work is left out. So we will write part of work left out, that means still not done. So if the entire work is taken as 1, the fraction total is always 1. So if I take the entire work as 1, from there I have to subtract what is the part or fraction of work that is already done. Already done by both of them, 8 by 15. So when you subtract, how will you do? 1 by nothing is given. Just take the denominator as 1. So what is the LCM between 1 and any number? It is the number itself, 15. Now on top compare 1 into how much gives you 15? 15. That 15 if you multiply with 1 gives you a minus. 15 into how much gives 15? 1. That 1 if you multiply with the numerator 8. So 15 minus 8 will be how much? 7 by 15. Okay? So this is the answer to the second question. What is the fraction or part of what? Work left out. The total work minus the amount of fraction of work that is done. If you do, you will arrive at the second answer. Now only thing you have to remember, when the question is having part, you have to find the answer in fraction. Question number 17, a certain number means there is a number which is not known to you, is added with 5 by 8. So that number is added to the fraction 5 by 8. And then the sum is divided by 15. So the number, let the number be x. Because it is an unknown number, so let us take it as x. Now according to the problem, what do we do? This number is added to 5 by 8. And then its sum, the sum is divided by 15. The result is 5 by 24. So when you do this entire thing, the result will be 5 by 24. Find the original number. Original number means the number which is unknown to you, that is x. So by solving this entire fractional sum, you have to find the unknown x. So repeating again, what was given? There is a number, it is added to another fraction, and then it is divided by 15. The result of the entire sum will be 5 by 24, and you need to find the unknown x. So you will frame it up and then just solve to get the x value. So x plus 5 by 8. What you will do? Next step. X is a singular number. Take 1 as the denominator. So the LCM of 1 and 8 will give you 8. 1 into how much gives 8? 8. That 8 will be multiplied with x. Plus 8 into how much gives 8? Comparing the denominators, 8 ones are 8. So 1 into 5. So we have added this two fraction which is given on top. This entire thing has to be divided with 15, and then we get 5 by 24. Now I am doing in the right hand side. Now 15 is divided by over here. If 15 changes side, it becomes multiplied and it will come on top. You know how to shift the numbers from left hand side to right hand side. So if 15 is divided by in left hand side, in right hand side it will come and become multiplied by. So next step, we can write 8x plus 5 by 8 equal to 5 by 24 is already present over here, and 15 was divided, it shifted this side and became multiplied. Now one more step. You can see 8 is also divided by in the left hand side. Now what we are trying to do is, we are trying to find the unknown x. So we will try to keep the x on one side and shift all the known numbers to the right hand side, and slowly we will get back to the answer. So 8 over here is divided by, when it changes side it also becomes multiplied. So we can write 8x plus 5 equal to 5 by 24 into 15, got from the previous step. From this step we are also taking 8, and when we are changing 8 from one side to the other it gets multiplied. Now you solve it. 8 3 is a 24, 3 5 is a 15. So you are left out with 5 into 5, that is 25. Now 8x plus 5 equal to 25. Now what will be the next step? 5 is also a number, shift that. Now plus 5 will change side and become minus 5. So 8x is equal to 25 minus 5. So we can write 8x is equal to 20. Now 8x is equal to, I am doing from here, 8x equal to 25 minus 5. Now we got 8x is equal to 20. Now again, when you can see 8x equal to 20, we need to find x. Now 8 is multiplied to x, we have to shift that number also in the right hand side. So 8 is multiplied to x, when it changes side it will become divided. So 20 is already there, you need to divide it with 8 now. So 2 4s are 8, 2 10s are 20, again 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. So x value is how much? 5 by 2. Now when you get fraction like this, where the numerator is greater than the denominator, improper fraction, you change and convert into mixed fraction. So in case of mixed fraction, I have to divide the numerator with the denominator. So 2 2's are 4, 1 is the remainder. And how we write the mixed fraction? 2 1 by 2. So this is the answer. The unknown number is 2 1 by 2, 2 and a half.